Hello, my dear friends. Today I am going to discuss what is concurrency control. Before going to discuss, I request all of you can share and subscribe to watch more videos. Now I have discussed what is concurrency control. This is the content, lock-based protocol, two-phase locking protocol, deadlock. First, lock-based protocol. A lock is a mechanism to control concurrent access to data item. That is, when multiple transactions access the same data item, they have some restrictions, and such restrictions can be implemented by lock. Data item can be locked in two ways. One is exclusive mode, and second is shared mode. When a transaction acquire exclusive mode, it can both read and write data items. Exclusive lock can be denoted by lock X instructions. Similarly, shared lock can be defined when a transaction access only read mode only, and he cannot write. So, shared mode can be implemented by H lock. Okay, when a transaction can access the exclusive lock, he only read and write, and when a transaction access the shared mode, he can only read. Both locks are mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive means when one lock is happening, other locks can never happen. So when transactions request a lock to a concurrency control manager, concurrency control managers will check the locking protocols that no other transaction continue with this lock. If that happens, then transaction never get permissions. If any other transaction access the lock, after releasing the lock, concurrency control manager give him permissions. That is, lock requests are made to the concurrency control manager by the programmer. Transaction can proceed only after request is granted. Until request is not granted, transactions cannot continue with its normal executions. Now I discuss the lock comparability matrix. The concurrency control managers can implement the locking protocols by using the matrix. Here H means shared lock, X means exclusive lock. Two or multiple transactions can perform the read operations, so it is true. But if there is read operation and another is performing the exclusive mode or write operations, then other matrix is false. That is, a transaction may be granted a lock on an item if the requested lock is comparable. Comparable means when both transactions perform the read operations, that is compatible. Otherwise, it is called incompatible. So, lock is compatible with lock already held on an item by other transactions. Any number of transactions can hold share lock on an item, but if any transaction holds an exclusive lock on an item, then transaction may hold any lock on an item. That is, if one transaction can hold exclusive lock, then other transaction must wait until the other transaction release that lock, release the exclusive lock. If a lock cannot be granted, the requesting transaction is made to wait till an incompatible lock held by other transactions have been released. The lock is not granted. That is, when transactions access the shared mode, another transaction requests the exclusive mode, he cannot get the permissions until the other transactions release the lock. Suppose this is an example. Suppose transaction A access the shared lock, then it read the data items, then unlock A. Transaction B perform the read B instruction, the shared lock, it also read instruction and unlock B, displays A and B. This is a compatible transaction. Locking A as above is not sufficient to guarantee serializability. If A and B get updated in between the read A and B, the display sum would be wrong. A locking protocol is a set rules followed by all transactions while requesting or releasing lock. A locking protocol restricts the set of possible schedules. A locking protocol means a place where transactions go and get the permissions to lock the data item. And this is the position where the another transaction releases lock. So that position is called locking protocol. Now I say that what is two-phase locking protocol. In two-phase locking protocol, we can implement conflict serializability schedule. In two-phase locking protocol, there are two phases, phase one, phase two. Phase one is going phase and phase two is shrinking phase. In going phase, transactions may obtain lock but may not release any locks. That is, when a transaction acquire is locked, this shared mode is still locked. It can acquire locks, but at that position, he never release lock. So this is going phase. And shrinking phase, when a transaction may release lock, then he cannot get permission to obtain another lock. That is, transaction may release lock and transaction may not obtain lock. This protocol ensures serializability. It can be proved that the transaction can be serialized in the order of the lock points. This is the lock points. Going phase and shrinking phase implements the locking protocol's concept. That is the point where a transaction acquired is final lock. This is lock point. Again, I mentioned that lock point means the point where a transaction acquired is final lock. Again, next portion describes the two-phase locking protocol second part. There can be conflict serializable schedules that cannot be obtained if two-phase locking is used. However, in the absence of extra information, that is ordering of access of data, two-phase locking is needed for conflict serializability in the following sense. That is, given a transaction Ti does not follow two-phase locking, we can find a transaction Tj that uses two-phase locking is scheduled for Ti Tj that is not conflict serializable. We know that a schedule is called conflict serializable if at least one transaction performs the right operations. So that operations can be implemented by two-phase locking protocols. Next, I described a deadlock. Deadlock means say a condition for a transaction cannot continue its normal execution. Suppose there is an example. There are two transactions T3 T4. Lock X B. Suppose transaction T3 performed the script lock on data item B and it transferred rupees 50 from account B and then it performed write B. He cannot release the lock. Okay. Then at that point, transaction T4 requests a shared lock on data item A. Then he can perform a read operations. Then it can also request the shared lock on data item B, but he cannot get the permissions since it can be accepted by transaction T3. So transaction T4 wait. Again, transaction T3 at that point want to access the exclusive mode on data item A. Again, transaction T3 cannot get the permissions since T4 access the shared mode. So here is the positions. Transaction T3 want to access the data item A, but he cannot get the permission since T4 access that, and T4 want to access the data item B. He also cannot get the permission since there is access by transaction T3. So this is the positions where no two transactions can continue its normal executions, and this place is called deadlock. Here neither T3 and T4 can make progress executing lock XB shared lock. Causes T4 or 208 or T3 to release its lock on data item B while executing lock exclusive mode A. Causes transaction T3 to 208 for transaction T4 to release its lock on data item A. Such a situation is called deadlock. To handle a deadlock, one of transaction T3 and T4 must be rollback. So solution of the deadlock is rollback of either of the two transactions or kill the transactions or any other transaction voluntarily release the lock. This is the steps to solve the deadlock problem. Two-phase locking protocol does not ensure freedom from deadlock. In addition to deadlock, this is the short question asking in different interview. Two-phase locking protocol does not ensure freedom from deadlock. In addition to deadlock, there is a possibility of starvation. Starvation occurs if the concurrency control manager is badly designed. That is, when a transaction gets the permission shared mode after he completes his execution, another transaction performs the shared mode. In this way, a sequence of process performs the shared mode. And when a transaction requests the exclusive mode, he cannot get the permissions until all of the series of transactions complete his execution. This is the case of starvation. A transaction may be writing for an exclusive lock on a data item, while a sequence of other transaction requests and other granted and shared lock on the same item. The same transaction is repeatedly rolled back due to deadlock. Concurrency control manager can be designed to prevent starvations. The potential for deadlock exists in most locking protocol. Deadlock are a necessary evil. When a deadlock occurs, there is a possibility of cascading rollback. Cascading rollback means sequence of transactions must be restart or redone or rollback. Cascading rollback is possible under two-phase locking. This is the short question asking in many exams. To avoid this, follow a modified protocol called strict two-phase locking protocol. A transaction must hold all its exclusive lock till it commits to abort. Rigorous two-phase locking is even stricter. Here all locks are held till commit or abort, that is, until all transactions perform its final operations and it commit or abort, then other transactions get all permissions. So this is the concept of rigorous two-phase locking protocol. In this protocol, transactions can be serialized in the order in which they commit. Using a rigorous two-phase locking protocol, it can handle deadlock. Thank you for this video. If you want more videos, kindly like and subscribe. Thank you for today.